Hello class, now we're going to work on some material in chapter 7, and this section or this chapter is about syringes. The best way to handle this kind of material is to basically look at the free textbook website. Remember, you have a link inside your Moodle course. And so I'm going to click on the free textbook website and I'm going to go to chapter 7. So let me pull down chapter 7. I'm going to click on go. And then I'm going to click on practice questions. On this practice question section, you are going to get a chance to practice reading the scales on an interval. So imagine that you're looking at a syringe, but it has numbers on it, and then it has little tick lines or little marks in between the numbers, and you have to be able to figure out what the reading is at certain positions. So for example, on number one here, we have an arrow pointing to a position somewhere between 2 and 3. Well, if you look at this, you can realize that the segment from 2 to 3 is 1 unit long, and it's divided up into 5 segments. So if you were to type 1 divided by 5 on your calculator, you would get 0.2, or 2 tenths. What that means is every tick mark is 2 tenths more than the previous number. So if you start at 2, you will have 2. Your next tick mark will be 2 and 2 tenths, then 2 and 4 tenths, 2 and 6 tenths, 2 and 8 tenths, and then 3. So your reading at the arrow would be 2.6, 2 and 6 tenths. Now let's pretend we're looking at another syringe where you have this information on it. You have an arrow pointing between 30 and 40, and so you're trying to decide what is the reading at the arrow. Keep in mind that the distance between 30 and 40 is 10 units, whatever the unit is, and it's broken up into 2 segments. Well, 10 divided by 2 is 5, which means every tick mark is 5 more than the previous number. So if you start at 30, the next tick mark would be 35, which is where the arrow's at, and the next tick mark would be at 40. So my reading at the arrow would be 35. What about this one? What you're reading at the arrow, and you have an arrow pointing to a position between 1/2 and 1. Well, the distance between 1/2 and 1 is just a half, and then notice that distance is broken up into 5 segments. Half divided by 5 is 1/10. You'll see 0.1 on your calculator. So 0.5 divided by 5 is 0.1. That means each tick mark is 1/10 more than what you had on the previous reading. So 1/2, that's 0.5, the next one is 0.6, the next one's 0.7, the next one's 0.8, and then lastly 0.9 and 1. The reading would be 0.8 at the arrow. Okay, what about this one? You have a syringe, and on the syringe you have some tick marks, and you have something between 30 and 40, and you filled it up to the arrow position. What is that reading? Well, the distance between 30 and 40 is 10 units, and it's broken up into 5 segments. So 10 divided by 5 would be 2. So each tick mark is 2 more than what you had before. So 30 plus 2 is 32, plus 2 more is 34, 36, 38, and 40. But your reading at the arrow would be 34. All right, how about number 5? You have on a syringe an arrow pointing to a position between 2/10 and 3/10. Make sure you can see the decimal there. 2/10 and 3/10, which means you're looking at a distance of 0.1. If you count the segments, it's actually divided up into 10 segments, and these are smaller, but take your time to count them. And that means each segment or each tick mark is 1/100 more than what you had on the previous number. So every time I move from one position to the next, I will add on 1/100 or 0.01. So this next one will be 0.21, 0.22, 0.23, 0.24, 0.25, 0.26, that's at my arrow, 0.27, 0.28, 0.29, and then 0.3. So 0.26 will be the reading at my arrow, but each one is 1/100 of a unit long. Okay, how about this one? Between 50 and 60, you have an arrow on a syringe and it's pointing to a position. 50 and 60 subtracted will give you 10. You have 10 units that this is broken up into, 10 segments, so 10 divided by 10 is 1. Each one of these would be one unit more than the previous one. So 50, 51, 52, 53, 54, 55, 56, 57, 58, and then 59 and 60. So 58 would be our reading at this arrow. How about number 7? You have on a syringe two numbers, 0 and 0.1. So again, it's 1/10 of a distance between those two numbers, and you have 10 segments. So if you have 1/10 divided by 10, each one again is 0.01 or 1/100. Well, when I count 1/100 above 0, each time I get 0.01, 0.02, that's my reading at the arrow, and then I could continue counting 0.03, 0.04, 0.05, 0.06, 0.07, 0.08, 0.09, and then 0.1. Okay, what about number 8? You have a syringe and it has readings between 0 and 1, and you have an arrow pointing to that position. If you notice again, it's one unit from 0 to 1 divided up into 5 segments. Each segment or each tick mark is 2/10 more than the previous one. So 0.2 would be the next position, 0.4, 0.6, 0.8, and then 1. So 0.4 would be the reading at the arrow. How about number 9? You have on a syringe the numbers 80 to 90 with these tick marks, and you've got it filled up to this arrow. What is your reading at the arrow? The distance between 90 and 80 is 10 units. This syringe has been divided up into 5 segments in between 80 and 90, so 10 divided by 5 is 2. So each one is 2 units, so 82, 84, 86, 88, and then 90. And number 10, you've got a syringe here and it has on it marked between 0.8 and 0.9, so 8/10 and 9/10. What is the reading at the arrow? Now this one might seem a little bit easier because it looks like it's right in the middle, which actually it is, and it's 0.85, but keep in mind, you would take the distance between the 0.8 and 0.9, which is 1/10, divide it by 10 segments, which would be 1/100, and each little tick mark is 1/100 above the previous number, which is why you end up with 5/100 after the 0.8. So it's right in the middle. Now keep in mind, you can submit your answers for grading. You can look at this screen and see that we got 100% correct. And if you were to scroll all the way down to the bottom, you would see your answer, which every one of these were correct, and then where you can email your results. Keep in mind that I'll ask you to type your name first and last. Check the boxes, me and instructor, type your email addresses for you and for myself, and then change from text to HTML in both boxes. Once you've done those pieces, you'll email the results, and you can always email me quizzes you have been working on. Later on, I'll give you another opportunity for an extra credit quiz, so pay attention to instructions. And I'll come back later with another video about how to calculate the dose, looking at a syringe and a label.